Joe Biden's a disgrace to this country.
He's a disgrace, and so are all the to the left and the rhinos, the globalists.
They kill them all.
Sounds like everybody's a crook except Donald Trump.
It is. That's how I feel.
We love Trump. Let's go, Brandon. Let's go.
Donald Trump's a commander in chief. Biden runs the D.C., the 10 square mile area of D.C. Trump's running the rest of the show.
America first, protects freedoms for all, reigns in the federal government, and loyally follows the one true leader of the Republican Party, and you know who that is.
Begins with the airing of grievances.
The FBI and the Justice Department have become vicious monsters. The Biden regime is trying to put their political opponents in jail. The shameful raid and break-in of my home, Mar-a-Lago, was a travesty of justice. The evil and malice of this demented persecution of you and me, Russia, 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 was a hoax. It was developed by Hillary Clinton and a group of people, small group around a kitchen table. The Democrats have an advantage in elections because of a lot of things aside from the fact they cheat like hell.
Oh, God.
I've named him Deranged Jack Smith. Ron DeSanctimonious, his campaign, which is dying like a falling bird from the sky.
Bill Barr is a fat pig. He's a slob. He's a fat pig.
Says, what about Christie? He's a fat pig. Christie, sir, I'm sorry. He is not a fat pig.
You stay classy, San Diego.
Our country's going to hell. Our country is going to hell. We're like a third world nation. Our biggest threat remains the sick, sinister, and evil people from within our own country. We will root out the communists, Marxists, fascists, and the radical left thugs that live like vermin. And a general who's a fantastic general actually said to me, sir, I've been on the battlefield. Men have gone down on my left and on my right. I stood on hills where soldiers were killed. But I believe the bravest thing I've ever seen was the night you went onto that stage with Hillary Clinton after what happened. And then that woman asked you the first question about it. And I said, locker room talk. It's locker room talk. What the hell? I was in South Carolina. I met with a boat company, the great boat company, really make a lot of boats, very beautiful fishing boats and everything else. And he said, sir, they're going to want us to go all battery. And I asked him, I said, let me ask you a question. And he said, nobody's ever asked me this question. He said, if a boat goes in because, you know, the batteries, he told me, are so heavy, he doesn't even know if the boats will float. And they take a lot of room, like the entire boat. So I said, if you have a boat, and because of the fact that your battery is very heavy and big, let's say it sinks. What happens to you if you're sitting on top of a boat and it sinks and the whole boat is a battery? Do you get electrocuted? And what would happen if you look over there and you see a shark about 10 yards away? Would you go for the electrocution or would you go into the shark? And I told him, but I know what I do. I will take electrocution every single day. And he said, nobody's ever asked me this question. Jimmy Carter, who, by the way, is the happiest man around today, because he is no longer considered a bad president. In fact, compared to crooked Joe Biden, I probably think he's considered one of the most brilliant people on earth. He's a happy man, which is good. We will begin the largest domestic deportation operation in American history. And I'll implement strong and ideological screenings for all immigrants. For any radical left charity, nonprofit, or so-called aid organization supporting these caravans and illegal aliens, we will prosecute them.
We are looking at birthright citizenship very seriously. It's frankly ridiculous.
Very simply, if you rob a store, you can fully expect to be shot as you are leaving that store. Shot!
Hundreds of people yesterday walked into a department store and just walked out with everything. You can solve that in 1 hour. You have to treat the first one out the door of the next time it happens extremely tough. That means anything you want to do. And as soon as that word gets out and you let people know, from now on, you don't walk out with aspirin.